after this. After this. Solid cylinder. Tell me what is the moment of inertia of the solid cylinder? About this axis, it's a solid cylinder, mass and radius R. Is all the mass located at distance capital R? No. MR square by 2, because you can imagine it as if made up of this stack on top of each other. Fine. So for solid cylinder also, the moment of inertia is MR square by 2. Okay? Alright, so this is the solid cylinder's moment of inertia. Please write down a thin rod. Just write rod. Here is a rod. Okay, then you need to find out moment of inertia of this rod about the axis which passes through the end and perpendicular to the rod. The axis is this axis. So how it will rotate? Like this. Or it will rotate like that. This is also that axis about which it rotates. Fine? Find out moment of inertia. The method is exactly the same the way we have derived the center of mass for the rod earlier. Total length is L and total mass is M. ML. Should it be ML square? Is all the mass located at the distance of L from this line? No. Should it be less than ML square or more than ML square? Less than ML square, right? So if you get answer which is more than ml square or equal to ml square, then that is wrong. How will you take dm? Take dm over here at a distance of x, let us say. This is dm at a distance of x. The width of this is dx. ml square by 3 is right. All of you please do it. Get it yourself. You feel a lot more confident. You're anyway sitting in chair and doing this. Better if you learn it, why to waste time? Great nonsense. What is the moment of inertia of this dm? X square dm. This I have to integrate to find the total moment of inertia. Yes or no? Now I can't integrate this because dm is not written in terms of x. So I have to write dm in terms of dx. Mass of dx is dm, yes or no? Total L length has mass capital L. So x dx length will have m by L into dx mass. Okay, so basically dm is m by L into dx. Mass per unit length into dx. Okay, because the mass is distributed in the length. In the case of this, the mass was distributed on the surface. So that is why in the case of this, you have taken mass divided by area. Because it was distributed in area. Now it is distributed in the length. That's why mass per length. Okay? So when you substitute it, you get integral of x square into m by L dx. M by L is constant, comes out of integral. What is integral x square dx? X cube by 3, 0 to L. It will be L cube by 3 or L and L. 1 L from denominator will cancel away. So ML square by 3. Okay? Usually rods are hung from one of its ends. So that is why this moment of inertia is important. Now find out moment of inertia about an axis that passes through the center and perpendicular to it. About this axis you have to find. said mass m, total length is L. Okay, so here you are considering a small mass dm of width dx at a distance of x. So this is also integral of x squared dm. No. Which is x squared m by L into dx. Everything remains same except the limits. What is the limit? If you take 0 to L by 2, you cover only half the length. The mass over here will be also there, which will be at a distance, same distance. Yes or no? But listen here, you're changing orientation when you go L by 2 this side and then L by 2 that side. So your limits are minus L by 2 to plus L by 2 to cover the full rod. What is the answer now? See, you will face difficulty when you have to apply integral calculus in physics. Everybody faces difficulty. It's not that somebody learns by birth. But if you face difficulty and then resist it, oh, this is not something I want to do, then you never learn. Everybody learns from scratch, right? What is the answer? ML square by 12 is the answer. Integral will be what? X cube by 3 minus L by 2 to plus L by 2. So you will have m by 3l l cube by 8 minus of minus l cube by 8. So you're going to get ml square by 12. Okay, so whatever you're deriving, you must remember this. Nobody is going to tell you that moment of inertia of rod about this axis, that this axis is this. You have to remember it when you solve problems. But anyways, when you solve a lot of problems, you tend to remember these automatically. Okay? So moment of inertia for the rod, you must remember from the end and from the center. Okay? Right? Now can you tell me moment of inertia of the rod about this axis? The axis that passes through the rod. The rod is thin. It will be zero. Moment of inertia about that axis is zero because all the mass is at a distance of zero from the axis. Fine? Whatever you found out is about the axis that is perpendicular to the rod. How many axes passing through the center exist which are perpendicular to the rod? How many? This is the rod. How many such kind of axes exist? Infinite. You just rotate it. You get infinite axes. Are you getting it? There are infinite axes. Alright? Okay. Please write down. Hollow sphere. Mass m and radius r. Is the answer mr square? I am talking about this axis. Should answer be less than mr square or equal to or more than mr square? Less than mr square because some mass is closer to the axis. Okay, now I'm going to tell you a way to find out moment of inertia of this without integration. Okay, so suppose this is your z axis, this is your x axis, all of you please draw this. Y axis. Sir, suppose there is a small mass dm. This is dm mass. Where the mass will be? On the surface only? Mass will be on the surface, right? And let's say its coordinates are x, y and z. X, y, z. The origin is the center of the sphere. Okay? Now, let's say I want to find out moment of inertia about z axis. Iz. Okay? Iz for this small mass should be what? Perpendicular distance of the small mass. Square times dm. Yes or no? Now tell me, what is the perpendicular distance of this mass from the z axis? What is the perpendicular distance of this point having x, y, z coordinate from the z axis? Suppose this is that x, y, z coordinate. This is z axis, x and y. Alright? Here is a point whose coordinates are x, y, z. Z axis is distance from the floor. This is z axis. I want a perpendicular distance from this line. So how do you find out? Root over of x square plus y square. All of you agree? Okay. So perpendicular distance of this dm from the z axis is root over x square plus y square. Right? Okay. So moment of inertia of the dm mass, let's call it as di because it's for the small mass. So diz will be equal to root over x square plus y square the whole square. So x square plus y square dm. Right? Any doubts here?
No.
Now there will be multiple such particles. Right? So you have to add up all that to find the total moment of inertia. So iz is summation of xi square plus yi square times dm. This is the moment of inertia of the entire sphere about the z-axis. Any doubt? Now tell me what should be ix. Ix will be what? Summation of yi square plus zi square times dm. I, y will be x square plus z square times dn.
So the arguments of submarine will take summation.
You can integrate here also. Summation integration are same. Okay? Listen here. I want to tell you how to get without integration also. Now, is iz, ix, and iy all are equal or not? It's a sphere. Any line passing through the center is same in all aspects, right? So ix is equal to iy is equal to iz. So if you add it up, it will be 3 times iz is equal to what? 2 times of summation, please do it your own, x square plus y square plus z square times dm. Do you get this? This is what you get or not? Right? And can you tell me what is x square plus y square plus z square? What is it?
The distance
of the surface from the center, what it is? Radius. Radius square. Right? So this entire bracket thing is r square, which is a constant for whichever x, y, z you take. Getting it? So you will get 3 times of iz is equal to 2 times summation of r square dm. So r square is constant, so comes out 3 times iz is 2 r square summation of dm. What is summation of dm? Total mass. So iz is 2 mr square by 3. So moment of inertia of the hollow sphere of mass m and radius r is 2 by 3 mr square. The axis should pass through the center. What? 3? This is r square. This is the distance of a point from the center.
Why did you equate
for these 3 i's? See, if it is a sphere, moment of inertia about any line passing through the center should be same, because this axis is no different from that axis. It's a sphere, it is three-dimensional symmetrical figure. That is why I have taken Iz, Ix and Iy all three equal. Due to symmetry, all of this comes. Okay, now you can choose to integrate also. The way we have found out the center of mass location of a hemisphere, similar way you can follow and get the answer after integrating. That is your homework. Please write it down. The homework is to determine the moment of inertia using integration for the hollow sphere. Integration is easier or this is easier? But this is tricky actually. Integration is straightforward. When you learn it, it becomes simpler. Okay, so the homework is to find out moment of inertia of the hollow sphere using integration. How you integrate? You assume a ring below. Here you assume a ring like this, the way we have done it for hemisphere. And you take angle theta like this, and this is d theta. You remember? We got the radius of this ring as r sin theta, and the width of the ring is r d theta. Okay, so you can do mass per area into the area of the ring. Try to do it your own.